Hello and welcome to NCPA on Stage, where we delve into the breathtaking performances at China's National Center for the Performing Arts. I'm your host, Yingying. Today we're exploring Italian composer Giuseppe Verdi's three-act opera, Un ballo in Maschera, which has just been staged at the NCPA during the May Day holiday. Set in Sweden during the 18th century, this opera tells a story about a king who falls deeply in love with the wife of his best friend. Although nothing happened, the friend killed the king because of anger and jealousy, but the king forgave everyone before he died. Stay tuned as we unravel this exciting story of love, jealousy, and forgiveness on stage at the NCPA. I'm now joined by esteemed guest from the NCPA production of Un ballo in Maschera, Maestro LÜ Jia, the conductor of the opera, tenor Gianluca Terranova, who plays the lead role, and Ms. Wei Lanfen, director of the NCPA production department and producer of Un ballo in Maschera. Welcome to our program. Maestro LÜ, you must have conducted Un ballo in Maschera at NCPA many times. Do you have any special feelings or experiences to share this time?
Every time is different, you know. Every production also different, you know. I did also in Italy and also NCPA different times, you know. And the first time it was me. So this time is for me really something special, more exciting, more tight. The stage, you know, drama is much more life.
Well, the story of Un ballo in Maschera was set in Sweden, telling a historical fact. The Swedish king was assassinated during a masked ball. Maestro LÜ, could you please give us an overview of the main plot?
So the story is a little bit strange because there are two versions. The one is in Sweden, one is in States, in the Boston. But the main story is the same. The king was assassinated by his friends. And also something between the love feeling, the wife and the king, they have a really love feeling, but nothing happens. But also for the revenge, and Renato, he killed the king. So it's about love, hate, jealousy, and forgiveness. So it's just a very, very human being feeling, you know, the love, hate, you know, forgiveness, jealousy. It's just a common sense of a human being. But in this opera, with the music, become much, much more clearer, the feeling with music, yeah?
Can you explain how Verdi expresses these emotions through his music?
Of course, you know, for example, the second act is in the mountain between the couple. It's not a real couple, you know, the lovers. They are meeting, some things express their, you know, idea, their expression. You know, this is very, very dramatic. And the jealousy is a third act beginning, yeah? Of course, you see also the very generous love from the king. End of the opera, forgive everything. Friends, even enemy.
Mr. Terranova, I know this is your first collaboration with the NCPA, but many Chinese audiences are already familiar with you through social media, and you've shared a lot of short videos on Douyin, the Chinese version of TikTok. Yes. What's your impression of our theatre when you first stepped in?
I think it's the great theatre in the world as a dimension, as a bigger of. I sang in Covent Garden, I sang in La Scala, and Metropolitan, New York, and I know they are very big. This theater, NCPA, in Beijing, I think is one of the most beautiful theater in the world. And I think there is a very, very organization, very good organization of all the different departments. Mm. The people working very well, I think. And I'm very happy to know this theater. Also, the China's singers is very good. The other company, the China's company, the tenor, the soprano, two sopranos, and also the mezzo and the baritone. The young and beautiful voice. Mm-hmm. So this is important for China, because in the world we are discovered now in this moment. The China's artists, the China's singers are very good. This is the moment of the China's singers.
Yeah, very glad to hear that. What do you think about the NCPA production of Ballo in Moscow?
Ah, it's fantastic. Mm-hmm. It's one of the beautiful traditional. This is the really opera, Italian opera, the really scene and direction, the costume, fantastic.
Yeah.
I'm very happy to sing in this production. Ugo De Anna,
yes.
I know him. I sang with him Madama Butterfly,
mm-hmm.
Giacomo Puccini, in a great Common Garden London production. But this is, in Beijing, this is very, very important as the great theater in the world.
Oh.
One of the most great theater, I think, really.
Thank you. You are playing Gustav III, the Swedish king, in this opera. How do you understand this role, and how do you prepare for the role, both musically and dramatically?
Musically is difficult because I sing a lot of songs and a lot of concertato different. There are the drama, there are at the beginning you have the first aria is to hope to see her, to see your love. And so as a baby, al rivedrà nell'estasi, and the orchestra is beautiful. After there is a drama,
mm-hmm.
so you have to be to prepare your body to change quickly the type of your singing, changing pa-pam, and drama and joke and drama and joke. Musically is very difficult, so I have to prepare 3-4 hours before I come here. I find some room, free room with a piano, and slowly I prepare my body. Oh. Very difficult. And if you do with the body prepared before, you can do very naturally, very easy. If you do without prepare your body, you maybe you can force some sound, you have some break, you have some problem during the performance. So this is my technical.
Oh.
Working hard.
Yeah.
Gonzo.
Yes, it's very important to have such a professional warm-up.
And dramatically is that Gustav is very difficult for me, because he's a character, he's a king. And after he is in love to his best friend's
wife.
Mm. So for me it's strange, because I cannot do in my life this.
Right.
I stop if I don't do nothing with her. But love, you know, love is dangerous. So I have to go in through the character, thinking that I love her, and maybe I do something very bad for my friend. So it's difficult dramatically. And also, as me, as Gianluca, like a very fun man, he won't be fun with Ulrika, no? But after he joke with the drama, he joked too much, and after he died. The best moment for me is the end, when he is dying and he say
Felt
to
really,
the friend,
yeah.
I want to respect your name and his heart. So the best moment for me is the end, very emotional.
Yeah. There were many beautiful arias for you. I mean, the Gustav III in this opera. Which one is your favorite?
To sing is the favorite is the opera with the complete opera at the end, when he decide to leave her. So, ma se me forza perderti. Ma se me forza perderti per sempre luce mia. This is beautiful melody. And after, when he decide to go at the ballo in maschera to see for the last moment her and say addio for the last moment, he say, Versi rivederti Amelia, the main theme. It's beautiful because in this moment I go very forward from the public, very close to the public, and see the most beautiful moment of the tenor.
Miss Wei, the other day I read some notes from the director of the NCPA's Un ballo in maschera, Ugo Diana. He said he would like to present the opera in a traditional Italian operatic approach. Many new elements in accessories, costumes, and positions of the performers have been added. So Miss Wei, can you tell us about these creative decisions involved in staging this opera?
Yes, as the director, Mr. Ugo Diana, said in 12 years ago, for us, you know, at that time when we presented this Un ballo in maschera, it's the first time presented in China, which means this opera has never been presented in full stage in China. So we really cherish this opportunity to give a Chinese audience a full picture about Verdi's this masterpiece. And so for us, when we decided to collaborate with Mr. Ugo Diana, we thought it's the best way to demonstrate this pretty new opera in China, new name, new title in China. It's very important to present it in a very classical and realistic way, since the story of the opera was based on the true story, the story of Gustav III. And also the story was a little bit complicated to be understood. So we thought the best way is to make all the characters, they dress in a very classical way and to make the audience understand more about the character's background and their status at that time. Also, because the story was happened in Swedish palace, in the real history, Gustav was a kind of romantic king. So the palace of his should be, you know, let's say spectacular and should be more more attractive for audience to be seen. So that's why we collaborate with Mr. Ugo Diana to create such a magnificent set like this.
Great. Do you remember those challenges that you faced in bringing this grand production onto the stage?
Yes, actually, every time when we brought some new productions, new complicated production on stage, they're full of challenges. But this time, I would more emphasize on the costume. I think everyone can see this. The costume in this production is very elegant and beautiful, and also they are more realistic, more stick to the timing of the story. And that's the challenge of a Chinese factory, because Ugo Diana is a director who took a lot of attention in the costume. And also for the Chinese factory, it's difficult to find the proper way of cutting this style. So Ugo is like, I think he stayed there for several days to help them and even to teach them how to make this special cutting. So that's why you can see all the ladies' costume looks make the ladies more slimmer. There are some you know, there are some tricky method to make it happen. So that's the biggest challenge for the factory, for the costume factory. But from then, this factory has learned a lot from Hugo Diana. After that production, all the costumes, when we contracted them, I think they accomplished in a very good way. Whoa. That's why I say they took a lot of benefit from this production.
Yeah, Hugo Diana is such a multi-talented director.
Yes.
NCPA has staged On Ballo in Maschera several times since its premiere. Are there any particular purposes this time?
I must say, Ballo in Maschera is one of the most beautiful productions among all NCPA's opera productions. So why we present it at this May? Major because when we deal with Oman, Muscat, the Royal Opera House, they like this production very much, and they thought for this kind of, let's say, magnificent production was not usually to be found now. For them, it's very unique to find this kind of production, very spectacular, very beautiful, and all the movement of the stage is very clear to make the audience understand the story. So they invite this ballo Maschera to Muscat to do the tour performances in this September. So before the tour, we should make sure everything goes well. It's a kind of a pre-tour performance here.
Oh, okay. Good luck for the tour and good luck for the opera fans in Oman.
Yes, I think for us, I think for all the Chinese, let's say, performing arts center or let's say some for different companies, it's the first time the Muscat Royal Opera House invite an Asian company to do the tour performance there.
Okay.
So it's a great honor to Chinese institution.
Right. Maestro LÜ, NCPA has just staged Wagner's The Flying Dutchman and now welcomes Verdi's On Ballo in Maschera. Both Wagner and Verdi were composers born in 1813, right? So what similarities and differences can be observed between these two composers?
Of course, they are two figures. It's totally different because, you know, different way, different thinking. And then Verdi, he graduated Milano Conservatory. Wagner almost self-taught. Wagner is, you know, also his experience, but the same experience because, you know, they are fighting for the liberty. Verdi for the country, Wagner for his idealism. Both of them, they have common experiences from their life. And of course, the style of music is totally different because Wagner is totally new with a recitative, always music together. So Wagner become very, very long opera. The Verdi is still traditional, but Verdi as an incredible person because, you know, every period of his life changed a lot. He changed style from beginning, early, and the middle, and the late, especially last two operas. You know, you see Otello and Falstaff. Already see some Wagner influence and Richard Strauss influence. So that's Verdi, you know, 80 years old man, still improve, still study, still want to try something new. It's incredible.
Mr. Terranova, as an Italian tenor, you must have performed many operas by other Italian composers. So in your opinion, what are the characteristics of Verdi's operas?
Verdi is different from Belcanto. I like Belcanto, I like Donizetti, Bellini, Mozart too, but Puccini, mm-hmm. you can love Puccini melody, beautiful, but Verdi is different because Verdi go very deep in your soul, very deep in the soul of the character, mm-hmm. and he can change music. You know, Puccini music is a style of music. You can recognize Puccini. It's modern, it's symphonic. Verdi is as a soundtracks of movie today, you know, the music of the soundtracks in the cinema for the movie today is he followed the drama. So in one moment you can sing la da 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 a song, and in another moment you can sing some dramatic concertato with other people. So it's very different music in one score, Verdi. Mm-hmm. It's different.
Yeah, a lot of people, a lot of audiences in China love Italian opera compared to other operas, you know, like German opera and Russian opera. Do you think there's some natural bond between Chinese culture and Italian culture?
Yes, I think it's popular. Italian opera is directly. The Chinese people, I know a lot of Chinese people, are very directly, very immediately, very easy. Easy as not too much conception in the brain, you know, like the German people. Mm. It's very directly, very easy people, yeah. as the Italian people. Mm. So the music is easy. And also they like high notes, the top notes as Italian. Mm-hmm. The Italian make these loud high notes.
Have you heard any Chinese operas, like Peking opera?
For example, I like very much the final of Turandot of Puccini,
oh.
the Chinese version.
Oh, really? Is that by composer Hao Wei Yang?
Yes, okay. For me it's the best. Mm. I never sang, but I would like to learn if I will sing Calaf, for example. I don't know the other composition, but I know that there are a lot of many orchestration writer very good in mm-hmm. China.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to know better this music. I know.
Thank you very much, Mr. Terranova. I really hope you will come back to China again to give more performances at our theater.
Thank you. I will do the best, my best for this Un ballo in maschera. And I hope to see you again.
Thank you very much. Miss Wei, in addition to Un ballo in maschera, what other Verdi operas has NCPA produced? And how popular are Verdi's operas among Chinese audiences?
You know, in reality, we have produced 72 opera productions since the beginning. And among the 72, we have presented 10 Verdi's opera already. I can give you the titles. For instance, we started from Rigoletto, and then Traviata, and then we have the ballo in maschera. And then we have Otello and Aida, Simone Boccanegra, and we have Trovatore, and also we have like Macbeth, and also Verdi's last opera, Falstaff. So from all the titles, you can see we have done Verdi's work from very beginning to the end, to the last two operas. So for Chinese audience, Verdi's opera is I think it's the most attractive Western operas in China because of all the productions we have presented was full of melody. So the audience can be attracted in a very fast way. And also every time when we present Verdi's opera, all the productions, they are spectacular, mm-hmm. I must say. That's a good way to demonstrate Verdi's opera, which will make the audience understand the opera better.
I think also the grand choruses by Verdi resonated a lot.
Yes, exactly. You're right, you know. Among all Verdi's opera, I think he paid a lot of attention in chorus. And our chorus are very young chorus, and the voice are very fresh, and also they're full of energy inside those voices.
Yeah, right. since Verdi's opera is so popular in China, do you believe there are sort of cultural connections or a natural bond between Chinese culture and Italian culture?
I think there are so many common sense in between Chinese culture and Italian culture. First of all, I think the people from both countries, they are very easygoing people. So that's why they are more fond of this kind of so-called easygoing opera, easygoing music. They like this kind of music, full of colors, full of melodies, just because the people from both countries, they are easygoing and they love arts as well as the foods. I think there are no other country like China and Italy, both very much fond of food and fond of cooking. The people, I mean, from both sides, they all love nature as well as the life itself. That's why they enjoy good food as well as good operas.
Yeah, I think both Italian food and Italian opera have been a great artistic forms for Chinese people to know about Italian culture. I hope NCPA will showcase more Italian operas and welcome more talented professionals. Yeah, thank you to our guests. Thank you for sharing so many great thoughts and insights about Un ballo in Maschera from the NCPA. Thank you to our listeners for joining us today. We hope you've enjoyed our discussion and gained a deeper appreciation for Italian opera and its cultural significance. Special thanks to program assistant Lin, and this is Ying Ying from Beijing. See you next time.